Good morning. Check it out now. I got you stuck on the realness. We be the infamous, you heard of us. Official Queensbridge murderers. Tomorrow comes equipped for warfare. Beware of my crime family who got enough shots to share for all those who want to profile and pose. Rock you in your face, stab your brain with your nose bone. You all alone in these streets, cousin. Every man for himself in his limb. We be gunning and keep them shook crews running like they supposed to. They come around, but they never come close to. I can see it inside your face. You're in the wrong place. Cowards like you just get their whole body laced up. Good morning.
Happy Thursday. Throwback Thursday. Might be about you. Good morning, happy Thursday. Get your asses up, man. Good morning. It's Thursday, June 30th. It's the last day of the month. Wow, Lake of Salam, good morning. Good morning, Ms. Figueroa. Benji, good morning. Trapstar Feet, Mr. Ponte, good morning, man. Listen, y'all know the rules. Brush y'all fucking teeth. Make sure y'all brush y'all teeth, man. I fed the kids, you know what I'm saying? No, I ain't go to De La Salle. I'm on that type time. Y'all talking about this McDonald's situation and all that. This McDonald's situation showing a lot of the trifling parents, the moms and the dads, man. A lot of y'all trifling, man. You know what I'm saying? What's going on, No Philly? Listen, a lot of y'all trifling, man. No Philly in the building. Hey, yo, can one of y'all pin that number in there? 267-496-9829. We're all talking like we're on the mornings, man. A lot of y'all some trifling parents. Tanya Davis, good morning. I'm just Niche, good morning. A lot of y'all women, man, y'all exposing yourselves, man, as the trifling moms that y'all are, man. I ain't surprised at the trifling deadbeat dads. You buy for one, you buy for all, period. Y'all motherfuckers, man, I don't know what type of time y'all on, man. Some of y'all crazy. You know what I'm saying? Good morning, Always Lily. How y'all doing? Good morning. Thank you for tuning in. You could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with me, Iggy Raw. You know what I'm saying? Most hated. Philly's most hated. We gonna touch on anything that been going on all week, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you gotta feed the kids, Doc. Shaheed Akbar, assalamu alaikum. Good morning, Cannon. Tamika Sloan, how you doing? Good morning. So for everybody saying, no, he not supposed to, like, y'all some ignorant motherfuckers, man. If he not with her, you know what I'm saying? Doesn't fucking matter, man. But it just shows, though. It just shows how us as people, man, especially black people, man. David DeToro, good morning. Thank you for tuning in. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's been a lot going on, man. People getting killed. You know what I'm saying? Jordan Harris staffers out here harassing people. How can a state rep and the staffers be out here harassing victims of violence because they commenting on my posts, man? Crazy Chris, good morning. We're going to talk about all that that's been going on, man. Tamika Baker, good morning. Thank you for tuning in. Be right back on Facebook. Facebook, I'll be right back. I know how it go, man. You just got to come back on that job, man. Shut it down, so... Start it over for y'all. Don't worry about it. Good morning. Good morning from Houston. Shout out to Houston. Good morning, Chantel. It's Thursday morning. You know what I'm saying? Get your asses up, man. What are y'all doing? What's the plans for the summer, man? The kids out of school. It's June 30th. Tomorrow, July 1st. So, I mean, what's y'all plans for the summer? Y'all just gonna be on Instagram or social media all day, all summer, saying dumb shit? Is that what y'all gonna be doing? Y'all gonna be screenshotting shit that Ike Raw say all summer? What y'all gonna be doing for the summer? Talk to me. What's going on? Let me know what's happening. So, I wanna know how y'all feel. I posted the video of the young lady saying how she felt about the whole McDonald's situation, man. I would've went and got a pack of hot dogs, loaf of bread, and my son McDonald's the morning from work on my way to an interview. Hey, listen, Joe, we hope you get the interview. Make sure you dress for success, man. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody that's going out for interviews this morning, trying to get a job and all that, man. Yeah, man, shout out to y'all, man. De La Smooth, good morning. So back to what I was talking about. I want to hear y'all. I want to hear the women, man. If you want to call in, can somebody please put this number in there so I can pin it? 267-496. 267. Yeah. 267-496-9829, man. Sean Salad, good morning. People crazy, man. I haven't been on vacation for a month either. I haven't. You haven't been on vacation or you've been on vacation? Stan Holloway, good morning. Wa alaikum salam. What's up, Meech? Yeah, just make sure you dress for success, bro. Hope you get that job, man. A lot of people understand it's hard, man, for people. Some people ain't got no, like I said before, man, some people ain't got the little, appreciate you. That's my guy, Trap Star Feet. Trap Star Feet, you on that bike? Is you on that bike, Trap Star? Need to know. What's going on with you, man? Trap Stars, you on that bike? Oh, you was on vacation. Good morning, Miss Ali. How you doing? Good morning. King Cave, good morning. Cannon, how you doing? Angie Love, good morning. Angel Love, I'm sorry. So, back to what I was talking about. Some of y'all some trifling ass parents in the shoes, man. For real, man. I'm just being honest with y'all, man. Yeah, bike life. But listen, it coming from them bikes. I'm telling y'all, man, y'all better be careful out here. If your shit ain't right, if your bike is not right, man, it's going to be all bad for you, man. And don't come over here asking me, can I help you? You know what I'm saying? Tamika Baker, good morning. Once again, they cut it off. If they cut it off again, I'll be back. You know how they do about the music and all that. So, but yeah, once again, you ready? All right, that's what's up. Y'all make sure y'all send some love out this morning. My guy, no Philly H is on the job interview. You're going to a job interview this morning, man. I see you don't see your answer about the censorship. Springfield, what? White lady, please. What's wrong with these white people? They always want me to talk about a shooting in Delaware County. When it's a white person or somebody not black. Just like, look, I posted a video yesterday. I keep hearing about the McDonald's thing. What happened? Hold on, we're going to get in that. But let me address the white people real quick. Good morning, Ms. Shaw. How you doing? You at work now? All right. But listen, Peggy Williams, good morning. This is what the white people do. I posted about the young lady who lost her life yesterday, right? So you got the white people commenting, talking about how the news got it wrong. Right, white lady, please, exactly. They talking about some, yeah, the news got it wrong. She wasn't our designated driver. Ooh, ooh. They need to get the fucking story right. Ooh, ooh. All these fucking long-ass parents. All this dumb shit, right? Ain't nobody trying that shit. Somebody told the news that she was the designated driver, man. You know what I'm saying? This shit crazy. Y'all act like the news just make this shit up. You know what I mean? Come on, man. Her family know what was going on. Her family talked on the news, too. And she tell me to talk about the shooting in Springfield. Talk about the shooting in North Philly, white lady. Y'all know I play that shit over here with you white motherfuckers. Progressive white motherfuckers. Every time a white person get killed, they like the black people who only say something when a black person get killed by a cop. Right, she mad it happened in the county. She bring her white ass over here and tell me, this shit say unsolved murders in Philly, man. Not unsolved murders. I posted that shit anyway because this is unsolved murder. And 9 times out of 10, the motherfucker who did it probably from Philly. You know what I'm saying? So I posted it. You know what I'm saying? So the man was killed in Springfield, 50-year-old man. I think he was an Oriental Asian man or something like that, man. So he got killed because somebody, I mean, allegedly they're saying he was driving too slow. And somebody, it was a lady driving an SUV. She pulled over. Shiesty Hing, good morning, Cannon. She pulled over and the boy got out and shot through the window and killed him. So that's what she wanted me to talk about. All right, I talked about it. Clap for Iggy Roth talking about me. Clap for Iggy Roth talking about the murder of Springfield for the white people. But yeah, the white people always on that bullshit. See, that's why I be telling y'all black people, when y'all be crying and bitching and complaining, only when a cop or a white person kill us, this is shit they do. You know what I'm saying? Come on, y'all. Stop playing, man. People get killed every day. They get caught, shot, killed. I tell y'all, yo, if y'all really concerned about the gun violence, repost the videos. You know what I'm saying? Repost the pictures of the killers that's wanted. Nadia Diaz, good morning. You know what I'm saying? That's how the violence can reduce, man. You know what I'm saying? McDonald's 5, where you at? If y'all track you down, I can bring him in for an interview. What's his name? Send me his information. I get the McDonald's mom and the McDonald's father, and we can discuss it. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody else going to give him a platform like this, so, I mean, we can work on that. You live up here? Oh, Springfield, the county? Yeah, I should be out the county. I know I used to work out the county. Shout out to everybody who used to work out the county, McDade Boulevard and all that. So, yeah, black people's killed every day. I'm not the one for the bullshit, white people, so stop the dumb shit. I had to get rid of a lot of them on that joint yesterday because they was talking that bullshit. I'm like, man, y'all ain't gonna do that. Nothing happened at McDonald's. My Lake Salam, good morning. How you doing? What's happening with you? Heather Pachago, good morning. Good morning, Lisa. Nothing happened at McDonald's. It's a video going around of a man who, to be real with y'all, I didn't even see the fucking video. I just. I didn't even watch the fucking video. I just know if you're a fucking man, I don't give a fuck. If you're just gonna go see your son and drop some shit off, I ain't talking about clothes and shit. I'm talking about some grub. If I'm going to go take my son some sneakers or some clothes or some shit, I ain't buying the rest of the kids no fucking clothes. But I'm going to get my son some fucking McDonald's. I'm getting her fucking kids McDonald's too. They all going to eat. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. But yeah, I ain't even watched the fucking video. But they say it's a man going around that brought some food for his son and didn't buy the rest of his kids, the rest of the his son's mother food. So that's what I'm saying. He's a piece of shit for doing that, like I'm saying. Now, if you're together with a woman and she got kids not by you, you know them kids, come on, don't do that. You got to take care of them kids, man. Stop playing, man. So for all the ignorant, trifling women that's in the comments, right, real man shit, you don't even think about it. Like, I say this all the time, regardless. He only did it because he been spiteful for his big to his baby mom. Y'all know that? Yeah, I'm being real. I'm telling y'all. Like, you know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, that's what it's about, man. So for all the men that's talking about, like somebody just said, she out of pocket. And all this crazy shit. Vic, come on, sis, what's going on, man? So at the end of the day, y'all niggas out of pocket. Y'all some trifling ass niggas. Like, y'all, just because you type a long paragraph on social media don't mean you are fucking right. It don't mean you are a respectable individual. You're just saying a bunch of dumb shit. That shows, man. You shit crazy, man. I don't have to see the video. You know what I'm saying? Shit is stupid, man. Shit crazy, man. So at the end of the day, I just want to say that to the men and to the trifling women, man. Because a lot of the men just trifling and shit. They don't give a fuck anyway. But that's why a lot of y'all women not married. Because y'all trifling and shit. Go look at the comments when I posted. Where King's fly ass mom, I think that's her name. She, you know, she was talking about whatever. Everybody in the comments, they talking about she bitter. What? We talking about, yeah, y'all's fucking crazy, man. Y'all trifling ass women. That's why niggas don't want to marry y'all. That's why niggas be leaving y'all trifling ass women. Because y'all ain't got no respect for yourselves, man. You know what I'm saying? It's not about him. See, that's what I'm trying to tell y'all. It's not about him being responsible. We know he's not responsible for the kids, weirdos, as a man. See, that's the problem. Y'all not men, so y'all don't think like that. You have the stupid ass men talking about it's not his kid. We know it's not his kids. As a man, it's instilled in you. Where those? Y'all not men. That's what we talking about. Cha-cha, assalamu alaikum, good morning. How you doing? Rafi, good morning, Kenny. Nick SP, good morning. Y'all not men and y'all not women. The trifling ass women, you know what I'm saying? All y'all want to do is bash another woman on social media talking about she bitter. Meanwhile, I can guarantee some of y'all ain't feed y'all fucking kids yet. Y'all on this live with coal in your fucking eye. You know what I'm saying? Right, that's why niggas don't want to marry them, trifling ass women. But you got women talking, I don't want to be married anyway. That's the fuck you do. You want a man to take care of you, love you, caress you, and be there for you, and buy all your kids McDonald's, you trifling ass, lying ass bitch. Yes, you do. Absolutely. That's why y'all that's why y'all on social media typing paragraphs in the fucking comments, because y'all ain't got no fucking man. Ain't nobody paying y'all no fucking attention. Yes, they're very trifling, every fucking day. Hey, Nick, come on, sis, how you doing? Shout out to my sis. Minds binded by grief. Doing a lot for the ladies and the mothers and the fathers and the family members who lost their children to gun violence. You know what I'm saying? They will not be intimidated in the city of Philadelphia by anybody. You know what I'm saying? They do not receive funding from these elected officials, like one of them said when they was on the live. So let's get that out the way right now. But back to y'all trifling ass fucking women, man. Brush your fucking teeth, first of all. Some of y'all just nasty as shit. All y'all want to do is just share fucking posts all day. Go look at their fucking page, man. You know what I'm saying? All they do is share shit all fucking day. You know what I'm saying? All on people dick all day, reposting shit all day. You know what I'm saying? Dick eating, atting people. You know what I'm saying? Commenting on celebrity shit, telling them happy birthday and all this dumb shit. You don't even know Keisha Cole, you dirty bitch. You talking about happy birthday, Keisha Cole. Love you. Have a good day. Meanwhile, your fucking grandma's birthday was last week. You ain't said a fucking word, you stinking bitch. Sick of this shit, man. Come on, this boss. Yeah, all they do is troll. That's what I tell them all the time. They trolls. If you follow over 7,000 accounts, you are a fucking asshole. If you follow over 6,000 accounts, you a semi-asshole. You know what I'm saying? And that's the bottom line, man. There's too much dumb shit that go on social media. Y'all motherfuckers up here sitting there condoning a grown man, spiteful ass, bitter ass, grown fucking man, not going to his pocket buying McDonald's for some other kids. What the fuck is wrong with y'all? Stinking ass women. A lot of them women follow this page and they trifling and dusty as shit, musty as shit. You know, all they want to do is smoke hookah. Yeah, smoke hookah, go to their fucking page. Hookah videos, all this dumb shit. Yeah. They got all the fucking hottest shit. Yeah, the lace frontals with this car. Yeah, all that dumb shit. Yeah, I know. My wife do hair, so I know, I see what be going on. I know a little bit about this shit. So all you trifling ass women that's condoning this man not buying food, you some trifling, bitter, disgusting, dirty bitches. And you probably ain't even wash your fucking ass this morning, and you sitting on fucking live, typing comments, paragraphs. Y'all talk more on my fucking page, like I told y'all before. Yeah, the new men are boys, right? Y'all type more on my page than y'all talk to your fucking kids. You know what I'm saying? The McDonald's thing. Yeah. Right. I know the rules. Right. She said, I'm glad my kids fought. Right, John Dell? Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Right, Meech. I ain't with the dumb shit. You know what I'm saying? These trifling ass men. Most of these niggas on the DL. And they soft as shit. That's why they condoning the shit. They ain't my kids. Any nigga say that, he's a fucking weirdo. Your father's probably sucking dick in prison. That's what it is. That's what's wrong with a lot of these niggas. They found out that their dad was sucking dick in jail. Yeah, and then he found out, like, damn, dad, like, you told me he's a gangster. I thought, nah, nigga. What's up, Miss Cookie? How you doing? Good morning. All I was in jail for, that's what he tell his son. You got to sit him down. That's a lot of niggas got to sit their son down and tell him, yeah, son, Ike Ross telling you the truth. I was a nut ass nigga. I was only in jail for child support. You know what I'm saying? Niggas knew it, and they was beating on me, and I was washing drawers. I was actually washing other men's drawers, son. Yes, I was. It's a teenage boy out here right now that want to harm somebody because his father acting like he a gangster and all that. He was sucking dick in jail. Yes. So let that sink in this morning. Good morning. Thank you for tuning in. It's Thursday, June 30th. Once again, not January. It's June 30th, 2022. So to all the men that's condoning the McDonald's nut ass nigga not buying the hamburgers, whatever he pulls by for the kids. Yeah, they sucking dick. They some nut ass niggas and they suck dick. They not men. And that's what it is. The women too. Y'all trifling. Because y'all need to hear this shit. That's the problem with y'all. Y'all like following these pages. That y'all see with a bunch of followers and all that, and y'all think they just be Joe. And they ain't gonna talk to y'all like I talk to y'all, because I tell y'all, I don't give a fuck. That's why when people comment, when I post my shit about my guy Trump, then you got some dickhead talking about, I'm unfollowing this page. Unfollow these nuts. Unfollow these nuts. Good morning. Good morning. How you doing? Good morning. Alexis Logan, how you doing? Good morning. So a lot of y'all need this in the morning. Like the boy who called in yesterday talking about he got a ghost gun. He convicted felon with a ghost gun. He think that's cool. It's not cool. You're a dickhead. D-H, dickhead. That's what that mean. When y'all see me put that next to y'all name, D-H, that mean dickhead. E-Dub, good morning. Sound legal, bro. How you doing? Yo, so at the end of the day, that's what we talking about this morning. Rick Lucas, good morning. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he was washing drawers in jail. Yeah, be honest. Niggas, tell y'all sons. Tell y'all nephews. When y'all gassing them up to shoot these guns and bust these guns, because you talking about, oh, I was in the feds. Yeah, I know why Ike Raw talking about I was in the feds. Yeah. Oh, Unc, you was in the feds. Yeah, but your Unc was a nut ass nigga washing drawers, cleaning niggas' cells and all that. He got you out here busting your gun and all that, young boy. Look, I'm telling you the truth. Colleen Buck, how you doing? You know what I mean? Yeah, that's goofy shit. Somebody did that to him as a child. Right. Shit is crazy, man. Shit is crazy, man. So you got, look, it's another woman right now. Listen, I'm going to say this one more time, because some of you bitches is just dumb, and some of you niggas is dumb. We know he's not obligated, dickhead. We know it's not his responsibility, weirdo. Right, thank you. Thank you for saying that to us, Meek, because she's fucking stupid. See, she's one of these trifling-ass women. Just go look at the women. Any women who comment that, go to her page, y'all. Go to these women pages. Y'all got to start exposing these women and these men that's condoning this shit, Brian Smith. Go to the men pages. Expose these motherfuckers, man. Any woman who talking about he ain't obligated, we know, dummy. Stupid bitch. We know he not obligated. We know that. We know he not obligated. We know it's not his responsibility. Do you stupid motherfuckers understand that? As a man, he's not a man. Do you understand? You know what I'm saying? Niggas do dumb shit all the time. Quintella, good morning. Heather Pacheco, good morning. You know what I'm saying? Because they bitter. They bitter. We know what the game is. You did that. I ain't buying them kids shit. They ain't my kids. All right, you a nut ass nigga. We know what it is. So for y'all stupid bitches, dumb bitches, that keep saying he's not obligated, it's not his responsibility, we know that. But as a man, because obviously you never had a man for you saying some dumb shit like that, that's why you're not married. That's why you don't have nobody want to wife you. That's why niggas just fuck you and leave out the next morning. You know what I'm saying? Without telling you he leaving. Yeah, that's why a nigga don't return your calls. That's why you got to make fake pages and stalk your nigga. Yeah, because you're a trifling ass bitch. Facts. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man. Anybody else condoning this shit? So that's what I'm on this morning, man. It's Truthful Thursday. You know what I mean? So if you don't like it, like I said, get the fuck off my dick. I don't give a fuck about you following the page. Or you think I'm a good brother today and then tomorrow. Oh, you ignorant. Suck these nuts. I'm telling y'all like that. That's the bottom line. Because y'all need to hear this shit this morning, man. You know what I'm saying? All y'all, I'm going to fuck who you is. Family too. Y'all know. Blood. My family know. Y'all know. No pics. Y'all know. Stop playing, man. Fuck y'all talking about. What they not understanding is the kids have nothing to do with their situation. You don't ever bring, right, some food around for one kid knowing the others. Right, regardless of what. I don't give a fuck. Like I say, y'all hear me say it all the time, man. When my oldest was born recently, not only did his pop bring back food for my youngest son, brought food for me too. Right, as a man, even when we ain't together. Yo, you hungry, you want something? I'll be right back. What y'all want? Right. What are you talking about? What are we talking about here? You know what I'm saying? It's all the hookah smokers, all the hookah smoking broke bitches that be in the club all fucking night, all weekend. That's them bitches that can throw in the stupid shit. And them nut ass niggas. Reese, good morning, Cannon. You know what I'm saying? This shit is crazy, man. So we not going to have these conversations, man. I'm going to move on to the next topic. Not unless any of you trifling ass women who can condone this shit, or any of you nut ass niggas who can condone this shit, you want to call in and talk about this shit, or you want to tap in and show your fucking face and go live? Tap in and say this shit to the people. I'll bring you on this live right now. A woman. I dare a woman to get on this fucking live, Facebook or fucking Instagram, and say he right. And say he's not obligated. Say that dumb shit. I dare y'all. Tap the fuck in right now. See? Yeah. Tap the fuck in. Any woman, any man who could condone that dumb shit, you can call in 267-496-9829. You can tap in. I'm bringing the fuck in right now, man. Yeah, why do you think this show called Iggy Raw? That's me. That's Iggy Raw. You know what I'm saying? This ain't Ike Nice. You know what I'm saying? Ike Fold. This ain't Ike Fold. I ain't fold draws. Other nigga draws and I fold my own draws. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day. Yeah, please tap in. Any of you trifling bitches who think that man was right, tap in. Any of you download dick sucking ass men who claim you fathers, tap in. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man. Right, you don't bring one cupcake to the birthday party. That's perfectly said. So if it's his seventh birthday party, you gonna bring one cupcake? Oh, hit this mine right now. Let me see. He got no heart to say this stupid shit. Ike, you're on the morning. Who this?
It's Dominic. What's going on, Ike?
Dom, what's happening? What's happening?
I got a question about the situation. Like for instance, like I got a baby mother. She have other kids, and I do what I gotta do, but at the end of the day, I'm not like for holidays or whatever. Am I obligated to buy her kids? Every time I buy my kids something, am I obligated to bring a toy to their kids? Like, because that's taking less from my kid.
How long you been watching?
How long I've been watching?
Yeah,
since the beginning.
All right, you say you're not with her, right?
No.
All right, so I said this in the beginning, bro. I said if you're not with her, You don't got to bring them kids shit. I said, not unless it's a meal. I said, if you go over there with some McDonald's shit like this, even if you ain't with her, you still, yeah, get them kids some food. But no, fuck no. If it's just, I said this in the beginning. If it's my son's birthday, my daughter's birthday, I'm buying them clothes or whatever, buying them toys. I ain't got to buy them other kids shit. It's my son's birthday, my daughter's birthday. It ain't about them kids. You know what I'm saying? I said that in the beginning, bro. I feel where you're trying to go and all that. But yeah, no, I don't
understood,
give a fuck.
Understood.
Yeah, yeah. If you food, go over there.
Food is.
Huh?
I understand. Food is different. I get that.
Yeah, now how long have you been like still taking care of your son? How long have y'all not been together, but you still been doing what you gotta do?
My son's six, so we ain't been together since he was born. So I've been doing what I gotta do since he was born.
Right. And that's like, all. Now, when we talk about obligated, that's what you obligated to do for your son, right? You're not obligated to bring her kids clothes or toys on your son's birthday. Not at all.
But just like she called main man to bring her, like him or her kid, his kid something. But what about the other dads? Like, you know what I mean? They get a pass just because I got the bread.
Right.
Do they all get a pass? Like, they ain't got to take care of their responsibility because I'm doing what I got to do.
But that's something we need to talk about more. No, go ahead.
That makes it like you punishing me for being a good dad. Like, you punishing me for taking care of my... These other niggas ain't got shit.
Hey, look.
The longer you call me, you can make me look like the villain because you ain't even... Like, you ain't called the other dads. They should be the villains. They should be the ones being ridiculed for real, because they letting their kids go home. You understand what I'm saying?
I got to clap for you on that, John. You know what I'm saying? I got to clap for you on that because I talk about that all the time, and we need to talk about that more because some of these bitter women, right? Just like what you saying, right? They know that they got one good baby father. They might got five baby fathers, right? They got that one good nigga like you that take care of your son, so they going to try to use you. They other, just like you said, they get the other baby fathers a pass, right? But try to take that shit out on you. Now she's talking about, oh, he'll take care of his kids. No, I got one kid by you. Don't try to act like I got to take care of all these fucking kids. And you're right. It's a lot of bitter-ass, trifling-ass bitches, like I say, that do that. And I'm talking about that this morning because it needs to be said, man. It's crazy. Just like you saying, bro, your son's six. I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. You're not obligated to buy her kids nothing on your child's birthday or Christmas or none of that shit. And that's the bottom line. If y'all ain't together, you know what I'm saying? Where they kids, where they father at?
Right, where the other man at. That's all I was saying. Like, the guy, he did his part, but it's like, did you tell him to bring food for everybody else, or did you just tell him to bring food for your son? Like, bring food for your son, he hungry. And so then, me hearing that, it's like, all right, I'm about to bring you some meat. I ain't thinking all four or five of your kids got to get fed, or I'm not thinking that's my obligation if you got five different baby dads, or if you got five different motherfuckers taking care of their kids. Because what about with my kid hungry? Is this nigga going to bring my kids some meat?
Right.
I don't need him to.
Thank you.
Like,
that's real shit. You know what I mean? I'm just talking about the man.
Let you know.
No, I feel you. I'm talking about the men and the women who talking about this man. You know what I'm saying? He not. I'm like, yo, can they keep saying he not obligated? I know he not obligated, but as a man, like on some real shit.
You should do that.
Right. Yeah. Just like I'm saying.
Even what you got there, see the situation, like, I'll be right back. Fuck.
Thank you. I'll be right back. You know what I'm saying? Whatever going on ain't about nothing. But we know how it goes. Some niggas bitter, like some women be bitter, and that's what it is.
Facts.
Hey. But what's your name again, Cannon?
It's Nick Bean on Instagram. You'll see me in the comments, but it's Dominic, man.
Oh, all right.
Appreciate you, man.
Appreciate you, man. Thanks for calling in, bro. Be safe out here.
For sure.
See, when the fathers, that's what I'm talking about with these women. That's what I was saying in the beginning. You're not obligated to buy the other kid's shit if you're not with her when I'm coming to bring my son something for his birthday, Christmas, or whatever. No, where's they fathers at? What are you talking about? What are we doing? They ain't buying, listen, I'm not depending on them to buy my son or my daughter nothing. I got mine. Tell them to get theirs. Now, if I'm going out and get a little food real quick, boom, food, yeah, that shit ain't about nothing. I'm buying my son something because at that moment, when I buy my son that food, at that moment, or my daughter, the number right there, 267-496-9829. At that moment, when I buy my son or daughter some food, the other kid's going to be watching them at that moment eat that food. You feel what I'm saying? I buy them clothes, toys, whatever. They sitting there playing with their toys. They father should have toys for them to play with too. Or their mom should have toys for them to play with. You know what I'm saying? When I buy my kids clothes and all that, I'm buying them clothes because they got to wear school clothes, whatever. They need clothes to wear. You know what I'm saying? Whole different situation. Absolutely. You know what I'm saying? I mean, now if you with her, y'all together, y'all building, yeah, you definitely got to take care of them kids. Every time you buy clothes for whoever kids, like, you know what I'm saying? Even if you with a woman and she got seven, eight kids and none of them yours, and you with her, them your kids. You got to take care of them kids. Why you with this woman? Like, you know what I'm saying? So that's what it is. But yeah, a lot of y'all got to pick y'all mother of the children, mother of your child, and the father of your child wisely. Like I said last week, remember we was talking about Tim Morgan Morning, how a lot of us going to clubs, going to bars, had these one-night stands. That's why we was talking about the abortions, right? How they talking about women who had these one-night stands, and then some of them might lie to them, oh, I got raped, and they want to have an abortion because you had a one-night stand. You know what I'm saying? Because you fast in the ass and all that, man. And that's what it is, man. Yeah. Yeah, they go for the nigga who look good and be looking at the print and the gray sweatpants. A lot of the gray sweatpants got y'all in some fucked up situations. And that's y'all fuck. A lot of y'all women vicious. The men too. Men too. McNeil, good morning, Ken. Chrissy Crimiller, good morning. How you doing? So a lot of y'all women, just remember, y'all was liking them gray sweatpants and all that. Now you done dicked your head off. You find out he ain't nothing, trifling ass nigga. Come to find out that was the only fucking pair of gray sweatpants he had. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, man. So, what happened? What's not true? Somebody said something that ain't true? A woman with all these different baby dads are disgraced, but they don't want to talk about it. Now, you're a disgrace. You probably don't even get no pussy. That's the problem. So you got niggas like that weirdo. Niggas don't get no pussy, so they want to bash women, man. So for all y'all women, y'all got to choose y'all men wisely. And the women, y'all got to start choosing y'all men better. And you know what I'm saying? Maybe we won't be having these conversations about some bitter-ass man not buying some other woman kids some fucking McDonald's food. You know what I'm saying? Meanwhile, Jordan Harris, fat-ass out here sitting at his desk right now, probably eating some fucking McDonald's food with the fucking suspenders on. And his fucking staffers watching Ike Raw Page trying to harass victims. Jordan Harris and his staffers are trifling, man. I'm telling y'all. Crazy Chris. The shit that goes on in the city of Philadelphia, man, with these fucking weirdos that work for these politicians, man, are fucking disgusting, man. You know what I'm saying? So I'm off that topic. I'm off the McDonald's shit. You know what I'm saying? So if y'all don't understand it, or whoever was trying to call in when I was talking to my main man, too, Dom, y'all can call back. So, yeah, y'all got to choose y'all partner wisely, man. That stink better, man. Some stamps better, man. What stamps? Yeah, they be telling me she get stamps and all that. Stamps ain't got nothing to do with that shit. He supposed to buy that fucking McDonald's food. A lot of people don't manage their stamps. There's some chicks on here right now, Vic, fucking them stamps up. They can't wait till tomorrow when them stamps hit. Yeah. Why you compare R. Kelly to Tommy? Are you serious? What are you talking about? They're pedophiles. What do you mean? I don't understand what you're talking about. Yeah, you talking about, what do you mean? You defending pedophiles? Hold up, we got one, y'all. Let's see. We might got something here, y'all. Keenan Miller-Arisberg, good morning. Is he defending R. Kelly and Tommy? Who is this? Is this a lady or man? Who is this? Okay, Get Right Fitness. All right, who is this? Get Right Fitness 215. Let's find out. Get Right Fitness said, why are you comparing? Get Right Fitness can't read. Exactly, telling no bullshit. So, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Get Right Fitness said, why did I compare Tommy Blackwell to Robert R. Kelly? Can y'all tell this person why? Are you any kin to Tommy Blackwell? Are you defending Tommy Blackwell? Did you have relations with Tommy Blackwell? Are you in relations with Tommy Blackwell? What is going on here? What the fuck are we talking about this morning, man? Look, see the answer over here for you. They both like underage girls. That's a comparison. I don't understand what you're talking about. What do you mean? This man impregnated teenage girls. This man over here talking about. This shit crazy, man. You was at work for 18 hours. That's the fucking problem right there. You working too many motherfucking hours, man. That's too many fucking hours to be working as a black man. Are you black? What is your race? Are you a woman or man? What's going on? I don't know what's going on, man. Yeah. He told me, why you comparing Tommy? What the fuck? Can you read? Why would you ask me that? You asked me that because you seen the meme. What the fuck does it say? The real pedophiles are R&B. I don't understand. What the fuck you talking about? What the fuck? All right, are you black? Well, can you read? Well, I don't understand why you asked me this question. Can you read? That's what we need to talk about. Tommy Blackwell attempted to pop the trunk on his baby mom. Nobody else was talking about this shit but Iggy Raw. No anti-violence people. None of these weirdos are talking about they want to protect the women and all this shit, man. And now here you come talking about why. Compare him. You must be new here. Go look through the page. You'll see one of his children's mother was on here explaining. He was chasing her around in high school. A lot of his baby mother, one of them was just on here. They might come back on. Yeah, but nobody talking about this shit because the Blackwell last name. You know, the Enquirer, WHYY, and all this bullshit. I had one of the journalists, remember the journalist for WHYY wrote the article about Tommy Blackwell, talking about he won for a fucking committee, man. Because they so thirsty to be in the fucking newspaper. WHYY so thirsty. They vicious, man. But they ain't talking about it. I sent them the video of him saying pop the trunk. I had one of the journalists, Chris Flood, the drummer on here. They started talking about it. I don't know why. Are you on the morning? So this?
It's Abu Thaddeus. Good morning. Assalamu alaikum, bro.
Good morning. Wa alaikum salam. What you want to talk about, bro?
Listen, I just wanted to kind of reiterate because I jumped on here after you pretty much said what I wanted to say about Farhad. That little clip is layers to this thing. You understand what I'm saying? And number one, you got to look at the guy who had this child with this woman. Whether his child is the last or his child is the first, right?
Right.
And some of the things that he has done, yeah, I say he gets a pass. You know what I mean? Because he's not obligated. But as a real man, if you lay down with this woman and you had a child with this woman, you know how she was, then
hold
partially
on.
A lot of that...
Hold on. Let's rewind the tape. You say he get a pass. Who get a pass?
The guy.
A pass for what? What do you mean?
He gets a pass as far as, again, every time that he may have to bring food to his child, you know what I mean? And he don't have to bring food for them other children.
Oh, brother. Oh, yeah, father. That's what I'm saying. No, listen what I'm saying. Yeah, I thought, you see, you came over with a sound leg on my boo and all that. I thought you was a good brother. Now, this is what left. But listen, what are you talking? Are you condoning this shit, too?
If I'm condoning it?
Yeah, because you heard you say obligated. Y'all keep saying, we know he's not obligated, but as a man, brother, assalamu alaikum. Right, what are you doing?
Right,
what you talking about? He get a pass. Ain't no pass. What are you talking about?
Why don't you say he don't get a pass for that?
A pass for what? I'm asking you, what do we get a pass for? For not feeding kids? You talking about he get a pass?
Right.
For the simple fact, bro, of, again, what happened to the other fathers? It's food. It's McDonald's, Abu. Sound like him, bro.
What?
What are you talking about?
Hold on. Okay. So even when you're saying McDonald's, that's just one incident. How many other times that you didn't show?
Y'all deadbeat that. Listen, y'all deadbeat that. Let me tell you something. Are you a father, a dad?
I'm a father, yes.
Do you take care of your kids?
And a grandfather.
All right, because listen, I don't want your family to come on here saying, you know, Abu that you had on earlier, you need to take care. Because you sound like a fucking deadbeat. You're talking like a deadbeat.
No,
you is.
That's cool. I take care of others that ain't mine.
I know. So why are you talking about giving another man a pass for not feeding kids? You sound stupid right now.
Because the way she came off on the video, bro.
Fuck how she come off. That's your problem. Listen, bro. Listen. Don't worry about the woman. That's your weak men problem. Don't worry about how she come off. No. Yes. You just talking about how she.
Again, we understand that she's weak. Again, you look at that sat down. He laid down with her. Whether she had kids or she didn't have kids, and now he's paying the price for her nut ass, doing what she was doing,
and
how
five,
she was doing
four,
it. You understand
three,
what I'm saying?
2-1. Bye. Boy, bye. He calling with the Abu Suf, Abu, whatever, I don't know. Y'all weak men are disgusting. Y'all even got the nerve to be calling the head sometimes that bullshit. Like, I condone that shit. I don't give a fuck if you say assalamu alaikum. You know what I mean? Assalamu alaikum, brother. I don't give a fuck about that shit. You's a weirdo. What are you talking about? Pass. We don't do passes. What do you mean? Come on, man. See, they try to do that shit all the time. They see this. Look, this. Yeah, bro. Wa alaikum salam. Assalamu alaikum and all that. Yeah. What's up? Fuck you want to talk about? We can pass all that. I ain't the type of dude. I don't use the religion on that. No. He on turkey time. That's the type of time he on. Like the rest of these weird niggas out here, man. I'm not the one. I know y'all like watching me because I talk and all this, but I'm not. You mean I'm different? I don't know what the fuck y'all think, dog. This nigga keep telling. See, you want to keep worrying about the woman. Don't worry about the woman. Tell me she out of. Don't worry about what she's saying, what she doing. What you doing about the kids? I keep saying it all the time. The woman, the kids have nothing to do about what she say to you or how she treats you or her fucking attitude. Don't take it out on the fucking kids, you weak ass niggas. We don't give passes. Come on, Abu. Right. Who the fuck is Abu? Do y'all know him? If that's your father, and he say he a grandfather and all that, he should be ashamed of his fucking self. As a Muslim. Because that's how you wanted to greet me and all that first with the, you know, Assalamu alaikum and all that. Abu, yeah, Abu, yeah, okay. I might get raw. You know what I'm saying? I ain't, you know what I mean? It's not legal. Yeah, this shit crazy, man. Shit crazy. This shit is crazy, man. I don't condone none of this dumb. I heard him say he get a pass. Fuck you mean pass? Don't you call him pass? Fuck you mean pass? Tiny so beautiful. Good morning. We don't do passes as men. We don't give passes. When a nigga get out of his car, say pop the trunk on his baby mom, we don't give him a pass. We expose him and let him know, let everybody know what he about. That's what I'm about. You feel what I'm saying? When men going around having sex with teenage girls, impregnating them, and not being a man, manning up, we expose them. We don't give them passes. You know what I'm saying? We don't give passes. Fuck is y'all talking about, man? Passes? Y'all niggas is weird. And just to show y'all, it's Muslim men too. I'm glad he exposed himself. The Muslim men, most of them be on, yes, the bullshit. Three wives and all this bullshit. Come on, man. Sound like them brothers. Let's talk about the brothers. Two, three wives and all that. You know what I'm saying? One of them electricity off and all that. Come on, man. Sound legal. We got to do better. Come on, brothers. If you can't provide equally for all three or all both of them, stop the co-wife stuff, brothers. Stop playing with these sisters, man. Come on, man. One of your wives sleeping on a fucking air mattress and all that in her mom's house. But you out here telling you this good brother in the community, Muslim community, all on Instagram, thousands of followers. Come on, brothers. Sound like, come on, man. Stop. One of your wives on welfare and all that shit. She about to get evicted and all that. But you talking about, yeah, I got your man. Come on, man. Stop it, brothers. Come on, man. Got this Muslim brother calling in talking about this man get a pass. What y'all doing? Come on, man. Our people are fucked up, man. And they expose themselves every day with the fuck shit. If you expose yourself, I give you the platform to do it. You can comment on here. You can call, man. You can do whatever you want. I'm with the shits. Come on, man. Shit crazy, man. Muslim brother calling him this bullshit, man. Yeah, but you can tell when weak men, they always want to focus on the women and talk about what the woman, the mother done. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, a lot of these men hate women. Yeah, yeah. Feed one, you feed them all. Ain't no way around it, brother. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, if you want to call in, give your opinion, 267-496-9829. Just don't call in on no dumb shit. And see, that's the problem with our people too. Some people try to say, well, that's my opinion. My opinion, you're not obligated. That's not a fucking opinion, weirdo. We know he's not fucking obligated. That's a fact. You know what I'm saying? That's a fact. The fact is, he's not obligated. You know what I'm saying? But as a man, supposed to do what you're supposed to do. He's not a man. See, he doesn't know what to do. That's the discussions we having. A lot of you women are not women. So y'all don't know. All y'all know is get on social media and talk shit all day. You know what I'm saying? Type paragraphs in the Ike Raw comments. Hey, Shane, good morning. How you doing? Crazy thing is, none of these brothers have any children when they're supposed to have them if the wife remarries. Let's talk about it, Sheikh Musalima. Yeah. Since the good brother want to call in representing the Muslims, you know what I mean? Well, I ain't going to say representing the Muslims, but you know, Abu. Come on, Abu. Who are you the Abu of? You know what I'm saying? Where's this Ibn's at? Was that your grandfather on here? Talking about a man get a pass from not feeding the kids? Come on, y'all. One of his grandkids or his daughter sang him like, now, dad. Why would you call him Ike Raw drink like that? Because they know who he is. They know his voice. You know what I'm saying? All right, here we go. I'm going to read this drink. For 80s baby, let me see. So how do you feel about the baby moms that be upset with their baby fathers because they are closer with the girlfriend child because they live with them? The baby moms who upset with their child. No, see, that's, no. The women out here got to do better having these kids by all these different men. Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. How do I feel about a woman being mad at her child because a child like the other, like the stepmom kids? Is that what you're saying? The mom, like, the mom is mad at the child? That's what I'm saying. I'm trying to figure this shit out. I'm trying to figure this shit out too, Ash. Hold up. Are you saying the mom, how do I feel about a mother being mad at her child because her child likes the stepmom kids? So to hear the brother, it just shows these brothers not doing what they're supposed to do. Exactly. You hear the brother call in, tell me he had boo. Assalamu alaikum. If it's brothers like him out here, you know, there's plenty more like him trifling and shit. Yeah. I mean, sometimes the baby father get a bum with their girlfriend. I ain't got time to try to decipher that shit. I don't know what you're trying to say. Yeah, y'all 80 babies is crazy. I don't know what the fuck that say. I'm not. You ain't fucking up my mind. I ain't doing that. Fucking my, straining my eyes trying to understand that shit. I ain't. At the end of the day, if you can't bring the other children at least a dollar burger or dollar fries or other kids, shit. For the other kids, then you a lame and nut. Yeah, that's goofy shit. Exactly. I'm a woman, and I think these women need to get together to be needing all this help. What? These women need to get together. I don't understand. Y'all, look, get y'all shit together this morning, man. The mom has to be responsible too. Yeah, the mom got to be responsible. We ain't talking about the mom right now. We talking about the fucking men and the bitter women. You know what I'm saying? That's what we talking about. And that nut ass nigga who ain't bought a McDonald's. So listen, if y'all want me to answer a question or whatever, make sure that shit make sure that shit is legible, man. No, yeah, I ain't got time to read that shit, man. 23rd and Diamond. Did you see the murder on 23rd and Diamond? No, I did not see the murder. Who was murdered on 29th on 23rd and Diamond? Who committed the murder on 29th and Diamond? That's a better question. Fuck saying the video. Who did the murder? See, that's y'all problem too. Y'all just like watching videos, seeing people killed, shot. Who did it? Let's find out who did it. Post they fucking picture. Post a video of them. You know what I'm saying? Crazy Chris says, stay in school. Y'all fucking me around in these comments. Yeah, these comments. I don't know what the fuck y'all on, man. Shit crazy, man. Young King. Exactly, Young King. Everybody need to worry about their own fucking problems, man. And y'all need to learn how to spell and all that shit, man. I don't know what the fuck y'all talking about. Call in. If you know you're like you semi-illiterate or you know you're illiterate, you really can't spell like that, just talk. Verbalize that shit. Call in. That way we don't know you can't fucking spell. Just talk. You know what I'm saying? They release video. Yeah, I ain't into that. I ain't into the graphic videos. If it's a video with somebody laying on the ground, bleed, I ain't into that shit. I don't need to see nobody getting killed. Who did it? I don't need no clout like that. You know what I'm saying? If they get the rules right from the beginning, they won't have these problems. Right. Get the rules right, Nick. At the end of the day, that's what they got to do. Yeah, y'all fucking crazy, Chris. Vision up. Yeah, my people in the comments, man. Some of y'all are some smart people. I respect y'all. But some of y'all are just dumb as shit, man. They always want to debate and all this. I don't want to fucking debate. Y'all motherfuckers can't even spell. Fuck your time up. Just call in. If you call in, that's what the call-in line is for. If you call in, you talking, how the fuck we know you dumb? Until you say dumb shit. If you type in dumb shit, everybody see it. They looking like, look at this dumb motherfucker. But if you call in, like Abu just did, like all I know is his voice is Abu. Like most people, they know you. But, you know what I'm saying? Well, y'all just, are y'all that dumb that you don't know you should just call in instead of typing the comments? Stop trying to look smart on social media. Yeah, this shit crazy, man. They speak just the way they type. Yeah. Yo, just call in. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with y'all. That's in there typing all this shit. I keep telling y'all. Stop typing this long, dumb shit. I don't even be reading that shit, man. So I don't know what the fuck, man. I'm buying groceries for those house. I'm buying groceries for the house, but that's just me. She's out of pocket for making a video, but she can eat too. Yeah, I mean, everybody saying she out of pocket. How she out of pocket? You might be out of pocket for something you post. You might post, you bought yourself some sneaks. You might be out of pocket for that. You know what I'm saying? Fuck your time off, man. Yeah, but please, stop trying to be smart in the comments to all y'all, man. Like, just stop it. Like, they are some fucking stupid motherfuckers, for real, man. I'm the only person going to tell y'all that because I don't give a fuck if y'all follow my page. I don't give a fuck if y'all like me tomorrow, today, or not. I don't give a fuck. Somebody else going to tune in to IG Raw. Oh, shit. I'm following him. Yeah. Somebody going to unfollow me tomorrow. Somebody going to block me. All that dumb shit. I'm going to block a motherfucker. Like, I mean, it is what it is. Social media. But stop Yeah, they're scared to call in, Vic. They're scared to call in. They're scared to call in, and that's why they just sit there typing dumb shit. And see, that's why it's easier for them to hide behind fake pages or put a dumbass picture in the fucking bio and then try to make this fucking page on social media. Raymond, what's up, Raymond? The lady's talking about, what if a man has a kid but is a closer with a girlfriend and don't look out for his own? Oh, but baby have a kid. Oh, yeah, that's bum shit, too. I ain't on that type time. I'm grinding them niggas up, too, man. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, man. Yeah, look, any of y'all that's saying the mom out of pocket, we don't give a fuck, especially the men. You know what I'm saying? Because y'all just dick eaters, like, at the end of the day. Stop worrying about the women being out of pocket, man. Yeah, they dumb on the phone, dumb in the comments. They just dumb as shit. Yeah, dumb motherfuckers, man. They typed the long John. Look, joints be this long. I don't read that shit. What the fuck wrong with y'all, man? What the fuck make you type all that shit, though, I'm saying? Like, I don't... If you want to type all that shit, go make a post. Go put that shit on the fucking post. Fuck you on my comments. I'm some... I disagree. I don't give a fuck. Disagree with these nuts. So you disagree. I ain't give a fuck. You illiterate motherfuckers, man. Just read these comments. Read the comments, y'all. Some of these motherfuckers... That's why most of them got private pages. They don't want y'all to know what they about. They post all this dumb shit. They don't want you to look on their page. Why you got a private page? If you got a private page, you are part of the problem. But you want to type all this dumb shit. Yeah. And to all the violence, anti-violence activists, to any activists in the city of Philadelphia, to anybody. If you did not post the video of Tommy Blackwell saying pop the trunk, if you did not post the information about Tommy Blackwell admitting to fathering a child with a teenage girl, admitting to going to the police, making a police report on a woman. Yes, Tommy Blackwell went to the police. Y'all see I posted that shit. So if you ain't posting none of that, don't post nothing about R. Kelly. You know what I'm saying? If you're just a regular citizen, you post shit on social media. But if you as a nonprofit organization or you running pages on social media talking about you stopping violence or you protecting women and all this bullshit, but you all on R. Kelly dick trying to get some views and likes from R. Kelly and you ain't posting shit about Tommy Blackwell, you are a dick eater. Yeah. And you want a DL. So that's what I'm on. So at the end of the day, yeah, look at the comments. Go read the comments. Yo, go read the comments on my page. I'm telling y'all, it never fails. You always got some dumb motherfucker going to type some long shit, man. Shit crazy, man. Oh, for real. At least Pop showed up. My Pop ain't show up. Yeah, my Pop wouldn't show the fuck up either. Like, my Pop, man. Look, I told y'all my story. My dad, I lived on 11th and Nars. My dad lived 22nd and Diamond. How many times you think my dad came? What? My dad, listen. What? So I know when I say I know when dads ain't shit, man. The violence in Philly, man. Anybody talking about you talk about the violence in Philly? What are you talking about? Yeah, man. People support who they want. That's what it is. I don't give a fuck. I fuck these people. I tell them anything. I support myself. I don't need nobody to support me. I ain't paying nobody to post my shit. I ain't no fucking dick eater. I ain't sending nobody asking them to repost my shit. I'm not paying for no promo. I'm not a dick eater. Dick eaters pay for promos. I ain't doing that shit. I mean, and that's what it is, man. That's what's wrong with our society, man. Our people, man. Y'all out here paying for promos. You know what I'm saying? He do talk about the violence of Philly and other things as well. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck they tell me. Nah, these motherfuckers just be weird as shit, man. Once y'all start talking about the violence of Philly, man, I talk about the violence. I don't just talk about it, I do shit about it. I go up Harrisburg and run down on Jordan Harris, fat ass, state reps and all that. You know what I'm saying? Larry Krasner, pieces of shit like that, man. Who your state rep is? Who the fuck is TH? I'm in for Philly. Can you pay me for a post? Yeah, oh, absolutely. Politicians can pay. Yeah, listen, that's the only people I accept the money from, the politicians. Oh, we can talk. You got something to post? Oh, absolutely. We can talk. Oh, you must have heard about me, I'm behind. They told you about you, off. Yeah. Zay for 21st Street brought a bet. Zay, you nut ass nigga. What Zay come from? What the fuck? Zay brought a badge. Wait, time out. Zay, where the fuck you been at? That's my Sully from upstate. Y'all know this nut ass nigga Zay from 21st Street, South Philly, man. He brought a badge. How much you buy, Zay? How much you put in the badge? Probably spent $2 too. Fucking nut. Made me lose all my fucking money upstate. We was up there gambling. I told y'all before. That's a nigga had me losing all my fucking money in poker, man, upstate. In 2010, fucking Zay, man. That's my Sully, man, little nigga. But yeah, these fucking politicians, man. Jordan Harris is disgusting, man. Y'all need to call Jordan Harris. If y'all in Jordan Harris' district, ask Jordan Harris and the staffers, why are they calling around antagonizing victims of violence because they comment on Ike Raw posts? I don't understand. Why do state reps do that shit, man? I'm for Philly. You still on here? You a fucking state rep. I'm gonna ask you. Do you ever call the fucking somebody? Did you ever have any of your staffers call somebody a victim of violence when somebody comment on one of my posts? Because you did. I'm coming. We coming back in September when the sessions come back. When they come back, we going on the bus. We going on the bus. Zay, I appreciate you. Zay, shout the fuck out. Where's state rep, man? That's what we done. Listen, so Jordan posted he brought home $53,000 for the South Philly softball. When he posted that recently, he lying like shit. South Philly softball. Don't no fucking black kids play no fucking softball. The fuck out of there. That's for the white people. They gave him the bread. Come on, Jordan. What the fuck did he bring for the basketball? Black kids like to play basketball. Football. Fuck you do about that? We don't play no fucking... Oh, yesterday, yeah, because I've been on his ass. That's why he calling around, because he was calling around to the victims. Yeah, he calling victims, he calling moms, dads, he calling business owners, all that. Other politicians, yeah. Talking to Republicans, parent, Iggy Raw, yeah. Why wouldn't the Republicans? You know what I'm saying? I'm a fucking Republican. The guys always take care of Iggy Raw, just like the Democrats. I go across the lane. I go across the aisles. That's what I'm telling y'all. Where the softball team at? My sis said over here. I don't know. Where the softball team at, Vic? Where the post at? Send me the post. I'm going to find out. They told me he brought $53,000. Y'all hear this shit? Jordan Harris. How many of y'all kids say, Mom, I want to go play softball? What the fuck is this shit? This motherfucker. No wonder he's sitting in there. No wonder he's sitting in there just eating all fucking day. And Zay, you from fucking South Philly, too. Jordan Harris is your state rep. You need to fucking check him. Because he out of pocket. You know what I'm saying? Who the fuck plays softball? Do y'all sons? I ain't never get nobody. I ain't never had a mom or dad send me a message or email or anything to my Iggy Raw. Marla Anderson probably. She said probably. Oh, Marla Anderson. Oh, that rec center. Oh, yeah. I know. Yeah, they all the cools with that rec center. Yeah. Like you always said, big homie, if you voted for these clowns, you are. Yes, you are part of the problem. If you voted for these clowns, yeah, send it to me. Oh, you on Facebook jail again? Damn, Vic, what you do? Fuck, I don't know. Don't worry about it. Fuck, it's 30 days. You be all right. That's why I don't even be on Facebook. I can't comment on that shit. You got to watch what you say on Facebook. They shut you down. LJ, good morning, Cannon. Yeah, Jordan Harris full of shit, man. 53. Listen, I never got a message, email, nothing from a parent saying, Iggy, can you tell me when they're doing the softball? Softball? What the fuck? Y'all knew what that's for. Pay attention, y'all. Pay attention. I ain't got nothing against the whites. You know what I mean? I'm just saying. Come on, Jordan Harris. 53,000. Y'all see that? Now, since Iggy Raw went up there and exposed his fat ass, he's sitting up there with his fucking taco meat all out. You know what I'm saying? This shit crazy, man. At the end of the day, man. So that's what we on. Wait, because my son played one season of softball in Jersey, and I was so glad when he quit. Softball, come on, man. Kids, listen, kids don't want to play softball. Not the kids I know. I never heard anybody say softball. You know what I'm saying? If they want to, that's good. Let them play. But at the end of the day, I know politics, man. Shit crazy, man. The Anderson Monarchs? Yo, so, yeah, that's what I'm saying. But how many black kids is it? Pay attention. Yeah, I know the drink. My son go up there to play basketball. I know what's going on. I know the ball run that shit and all that. Trust me. I know what these politicians get certain money to fund certain rec centers and organizations. Come on, man. Right. Pay attention, y'all. That's what the girl, that's what, whatchamacallit, I think went there. Ain't that what the jump? Monet won that. The girl, the 13-year-old from South Philly. What's her name? He don't do nothing for the community that he lives in. We've been asking for things. And got nothing yet. Yeah, Jordan Harris. Jordan Harris ain't buying nothing but McDonald's. Yeah, Jordan Harris is definitely buying some fucking McDonald's. His fat ass. He would have came with about 10 bags. Yeah, what? He would have sat down with all the kids, sat on the floor with the fucking suspenders on. Yeah, eating fucking burgers with the kids. Absolutely. I know it's more white now. I know. I just was up there a couple months ago, weeks ago. My son played up there basketball. I know. I'm trying to tell y'all, peep game. They do that shit. For the white kids, what about the black kids? Come on, y'all. Talk about it, man. Come on, y'all. Yeah, she went there, right, because they got pictures and all that shit in there. So that's why they fund them joints. Any Jones that got some fame or something to my famous one there and all that, that's what the politicians gravitate to. Them the community rec centers, they gonna fund and all that, man. So that's what I'm saying. Alice Cruz, yeah, Alice Cruz a fucking nut. Exactly. So that's what I'm putting y'all on. I'm putting y'all on the game. Y'all gotta pay attention. Jordan Harris said he gave $53,000 to the Marion, to the softball joint, to that rec center. Pay attention, y'all. But the staffer, him and the staffer going around calling victims of violence, talking about, I don't like what you're saying on Ike Raw Post. But I'm going to talk more about that later on, man. Because something need to be done about that, man. Maybe I need to call the Philly Dems and talk to Brady and see why a Democrat state rep is calling victims of violence because they comment on the post of Ike Raw. So maybe I need to talk to Brady and them, see what's going on. Maybe Anton Moore. Anton, you the ward leader. Before I go, Anton Moore, you the ward leader, South Philly. Got to talk to you because you told the people endorse Jordan Harris. Absolutely. So that got to talk to you. Find out why Jordan Harris is calling victims of violence. You the ward leader. Maybe you can talk to Brady with me. Find out why Jordan Harris and his staffers are harassing victims of violence. So we're going to talk about that. I'll call you later, Anton. You're my guy. I mean, about nine, I know you're going. I know you don't stand for this shit. I know you ain't going for this shit because this is crazy. Jordan Harris telling victims of violence. You lost your child to violence, and a state rep and his staffer is talking about why you comment on Ike Raw page, why you see this. Mm-mm-mm-mm. But listen, y'all, I got to go. Y'all enjoy the rest of y'all day. And just let that marinate, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to Jordan Harris and the staffers that's watching right now. Y'all ain't shit. And we on y'all ass. Change is coming. Enjoy the rest of y'all day, y'all. Ike Raw, man of the people. Yeah, Jordan. We're getting you out of here, Jordan. Jordan Harris. Your days are numbered, just like Larry Krasner. So once again, just remember, I'm Ike Raw, man of the people. You fuck with me, I'll fuck with you. You don't fuck with me, I'll fuck with you, man. The line? No, that's why I posted earlier. Watch the video that's on the page right now where y'all see he's sitting in the office telling the mothers who lost their children to violence. They was telling him how they got trouble calling the detectives. They saying the line keep being busy. And he's sitting there telling them, oh, I can do. I said you can't do nothing about that. Answer my question. What does accountability for repeat offenders of gun violence look like? That's why he kept trying to dodge the question. He has done nothing for the mothers who lost their children in gun violence. You calling victims of gun violence, telling them why is they commenting on my post? So you don't give a fuck about the victims, Jordan Harris. You've been exposed. So like I said, Anton Moore, you my guy, you the war leader. You told the people to endorse Jordan Harris, and we want to know why is he calling victims of violence saying this shit? Him and the staffers. So this is real beef, y'all. Enjoy the rest of y'all.